In the previous video, I went over how to use spatial queries. In this video, I will show you how to use the clip, buffer, and erase tools. On the Humboldt State Geospatial online website, I am currently on step 72. However, for future reference, be aware that these numbers sometimes change. In this step, I'm going to try to locate properties that are at least 600 meters away from wetlands areas. To do this, I will start by clipping the wetlands layer to the Humboldt County boundary. Then I will create a 600 meter buffer around the wetlands. Finally, I will use the wetlands buffer to erase these unwanted areas from the properties. Add the wetlands layer to the table of contents. The wetlands layer is quite large and made up of thousands of polygons. As a result, it places a strain on the computer hardware. To make the analysis run faster, I'm going to clip the wetlands layer to the Humboldt County boundary. If you've ever baked cookies before and used a cookie cutter, you will find that the clip tool works in a similar way. Imagine that the wetlands layer is the dough. The clip tool will use the Humboldt County boundary like a cookie cutter. What's left will be a wetlands layer in the shape of the Humboldt County boundary. In the Arc toolbox, open the Analysis Tools, then open Extract. Double-click on the clip tool. For the input, drag in the wetlands layer. For the clip feature, drag in the Humboldt County boundary layer. For the output, click the yellow file folder icon and navigate to your working folder. I'll call the file Humboldt County Wetlands. When you are ready, click Save, then OK. Because the wetlands layer is so large, it may take a couple of minutes for the clip operation to complete. Once it is done, remove the original wetlands layer from the table of contents. You won't need it anymore, and leaving it on will slow down ArcMap. As you can see, the Humboldt County wetlands layer is in the shape of the Humboldt County boundary. Now that the wetlands is clipped, the next step is to create a 600 meter buffer. In the Arc toolbox, open the Analysis Tools, then open Proximity. Double-click on the Buffer tool. For the input feature, use the Humboldt County wetlands layer. For the output, click the yellow file folder icon and navigate to your working folder. I'll call the file Wetlands Buffer. Under Linear Unit, enter 600. Make sure the units are set to meters. Scroll down until you see Dissolve Type. Use the drop-down menu and select All. Leave all the other settings as default, then click OK. It will take about 5 to 10 minutes for the buffer tool to complete. Try not to click anywhere in ArcMap while it is running, or the software might crash. When it is complete, you will see the new buffer layer appear. In the table of contents, remove the Humboldt County wetlands layer. Next, I will use the erase tool to remove areas from the properties that land inside the wetlands buffer. In the Arc toolbox, open the Analysis Tools, then open Overlay. Double-click on the Erase tool. For the input, use the Properties Away from Rivers layer. Use the Wetlands buffer as the erase feature. For the output, click the yellow file folder icon and navigate to your working folder. I'll call the file Properties Away from Wetlands. When you are ready, click Save, then OK. When it is complete, you'll see the new layer in the table of contents. Remove the wetlands buffer and the properties away from rivers layer. You won't need them anymore. I have satisfied the fifth criteria. In the next video, I will show you how to create a variable distance buffer based on a buffer field.